Welcome back to Baltimore. We are live here after the bridge collapse overnight. The I-695 bridge, the Francis Scott Key Bridge over the Patapsco River, collapsing after being hit by a large cargo ship just before 1:30 this morning. The search continues for anybody, any of the victims from this bridge collapse. And of course, a lot of other issues need to be addressed here as well. Let's talk some more about exactly what happened today. And we're going to get an expert view on this. Dr. Akisha Belgrave, she is the associate professor and engineering program lead at Harrisburg University. She joins us now to talk more about this, and I want to kind of warn our viewers, we have a little bit of delay for my questions here in Baltimore to Dr. Belgrave. But Dr. Belgrave, we really appreciate you joining us. Let's start with this. I think a lot of people are wondering, yes, this was a very large cargo ship, 95,000 tons, but it hits this support of this bridge, and the bridge almost immediately collapses. Are you surprised by that happening this way?
I'm actually not surprised at all that this happened. The way that the bridges are designed, we try to take into account every single thing, but you really cannot take into account everything that would happen based on the building of the bridge. I'm sure that they took into account all the materials that would be needed in case there was something, for instance, like a fire. Or they also take into account the height that needs that is needed for things like cargo ships to pass under. But this was a pretty large ship, and based on the size of the ship, it carrying cargo as well, and probably how fast it was going, as well as what I saw, it actually looked like it hit a support beam. These are things that were already put in place to make sure that the bridge would kind of maintain its structural integrity. So I'm not surprised that actually fall, given the impact and the location or the point of impact that the ship actually hit.
So this bridge is 47 years old. It's built back in 1977. So, Dr. Belgrave, any reason to believe the age of this bridge is any factor here? Or maybe another question would be, newer bridges, would they have kind of suffered the same fate here?
So I thought about this a lot today. Yes, the bridge is pretty old. It was, as you said, built back in 1977. There are a lot of things to consider with age. You have to consider or take into account weather conditions over time. Regulations might have changed since then, the type of materials that they actually use since then, with our, the type of, you know, things that were, that they thought back then would have been enough to suffice for building this bridge. A lot of different things probably change or advance. So we had a lot of advances over time. So I would not necessarily say that every other bridge will suffer this exact fate. But again, like I said to you, engineers take into account all of we take into account all the different aspects of bridge design, planning, designing, traffic conditions as well, traffic patterns that might have changed over time that are a lot better right now. So there are a lot of traffic engineers that do a lot of research on these type of things. But given that that bridge was built back in time, and I'm sure they were doing a lot of different inspections going on with the bridge, I'm not very surprised, but I would not necessarily say that every other bridge would suffer the same fate as this one. But again, we have to take into account everything that happened today, impact point, the quickness of what the ship was coming at, as well as this big cargo ship is what hit the bridge.
Absolutely. All right, Dr. Akisha Belgrave from Harrisburg University joining us with her expertise. Dr. Belgrave, thank you so much for joining us. We really appreciate that.